life is nothing but a genetic mutation. An accident. Your lives are measured in years and decades. You wither and die. We are eternal, the pinnacle of evolution and existence. Before us, you are nothing. Your extinction is inevitable. We are the end of everything. We have no beginning. We have no end. We are infinite. Millions of years after your civilization has been eradicated and forgotten, we will endure. We are legion. The time of our return is coming. Our numbers will darken the sky of every world. You cannot escape your doom. I am the vanguard of your destruction. This exchange is over.
Hello everyone, and welcome to my new Stellar's Let's Play series, where we will play, as you maybe guessed from the intro alone, as the Reapers from Mass Effect. Now we can't exactly play as the Reapers unless we would use mods, but we play vanilla here. So I had to make some slightly changes. I've also not completely customized our enemies. That's what you can do. You can create custom NPCs that you can also not just play as, but also fight against. And more to that later. Now to our home world, I just put some random names in here. They mean nothing really. They are unimportant. Our home world is actually not a planet. It's, as you can see, a ring world. Which means we will get a lot of science, which is very, very good. Because we will somewhat tech rush our enemies. Now, for our civics, I can't show them you, because for whatever reason they do not appear here. Wait a second. No. So we are, what maybe be a surprise to a few of you, we play as Driven Assimilator. Now, the majority of you guys probably expect me to play Determined Exterminator. But that's not really what the Reapers are. The Reapers have the ability to indoctrinate people, which is basically assimilation. Which is what we are going to do. Now, the real reason why I didn't really choose Determined Exterminator, it's not just because I played it in the past already, a full playthrough of that, but also because Determined Exterminator does not fit the role of Reapers. The Reapers did not want to destroy all organic life. They wish to preserve it, actually, which is not the goal that you would have as a Determined Exterminator. So the only real thing that would kinda make sense here would be the Assimilator, because we will indoctrinate people, and that will be our goal for this playthrough. And our second civic is Rapid Replicator, to build a lot more Reapers. Now, for our species, we are obviously the Reapers, and for our traits, we have, again, something to boost our pop assembly speed, which is mass produced, to help us even build more Reapers, then logic engines, which will give us more research, which will be perfect since we will kinda tech rush with the ring world, and this will boost that. And for our last and final perk, which will be a negative perk, because we need to balance it out, we can't have only positive perks, is high bandwidth, which will give us more Empire Spore from Pops. However, nobody cares about Empire Spore, so that's unimportant. Our ruler title will be the Catalyst, because that's what rules over the Reapers. And the speaker of the Catalyst will be the Reaper named Harbinger. Now with that, I think we are ready to go. Now our origin is obviously Shattered Ring. We use humanoid chips, advisor was obviously machine intelligence. And now that I think of it, what could also be fun is if we give him the voice, the broker. Yes, communism Reapers. Maybe for another playthrough. But yeah, this is our build. And yes, we have everything, so let's start. So here we are. Now let's begin. Here we have our beautiful ruined ring world. And Where are we? Sadly not at the corner, but looks good. So yeah, I don't play on a really large galaxy, 600 stars. With 10 AI empires, a few of them are custom made. Two of them are from Mass Effect, the rest is either random. I also forgot to show my cyborgs to you guys. That's what I forgot. So if you truly want to copy this build, I have normal cyborgs, so it would probably be better if you would go with Lifoids or something. My cyborgs have more energy credits, pop growth speed again, and unruly for more empires pull, which at this point could be maybe a problem slightly, considering we have two negative perks affecting empires pull, but I think we can manage. So yeah, about the custom empires, not all of them are inspired from Mass Effect, some are inspired from other games. They plan on greeting and mentioning the people who can name from which game or franchise the custom empire that we will encounter sooner or later is in the next episode. So yeah, let's get started. We have 2 minerals and 2 engineering left. Let's build the station here to get a bit more minerals. Where do we send our first science ship is the big question. Let's just survey all of this here with the first science ship. Then we go for here and we take all of this. There's also a black hole. Then the second science ship will survey the rest. Let's build it. Here. And let's upgrade our ships. Let's get all of that removed so that we get a few more alloys, because it's not really an upgrade at this point for our ships. I mean, we just removed everything on it, so it's more of a downgrade, and therefore we will get alloys back instead of paying them, which will be helpful for now. We will upgrade our ships again a bit later. Now for our ring world, the special thing about the ring world are districts, and you can see over here is a science district that gives us a lot of science. Now we need to get exotic gases first, so it will take a while before we can build that thing. It will also take a while to build an entire sector of this. Now if you have a Lifoid cyborg species, you could give the Lifoid the trait that it produces exotic gases or the rare crystals or whatever you really need. So that's why having cyborg Lifoids may be a better choice for your playthrough if you want to play this faction yourself with custom cyborgs. So let's unpause and see what our science ships will find. Our very first system has 2 planets. Interesting. What do we have here? 7 out of 10? Never. No. Forget that. You are not going to research that. So this is only a size 8 world, sadly. This is a size 14 ice world. Now the big advantage we have is that we are robots, so we give a fuck about what the fuck is on the planet. Normally if you play, let's send our second sentry out and go this way. Was the, yeah, so we're gonna go this way. So yeah, normally if you play with the ring world, your species would say, we love ring worlds, we only know how to live on ring worlds, so we can't really live on other planets. However, that's not really the case with machines, because we are machines, we don't give a fuck about what's on the planet. So, with machines, this is kinda OP and strong. Now we have to move for the science so we must explore a bit before we can tell him to go over there. So, question is what we are going to build here first. We already have an uplink node for Unity. Are we gonna... I think we're gonna decide it later. The Yacht Empire. I forgot what their bonus was. I don't know what we will get at the end of that event. Was it a Relic World? I'm not sure. Relic World would be nice though. And holy fuck, I just saw that. That system has fucking 12 minerals. This is a very good system. This is a good starting system. Like, we have a lot of minerals here. And a bit of energy. But I'm really interested in the minerals. What I forgot about was this thing here. Planetary Reaches. Because... Yeah, here is it. We can get the resources to build one segment immediately. If we just destroy this. Within 270 days, we have the minerals and the exotic gases needed for the research district. Which will boost our research. And I think what needs like 50 months will then now only need 20 or so.
System survey complete.
And another system survey. Yeah, we're gonna grab all of that. It's time to colonize this planet. We need a few more alloys though, so we're gonna buy 100. Oh, we found someone. Interesting. We're gonna sell a bit of that. Oh, hello! Apologies for our blatant presence in the universe, Reapers. We are the Mystic Order, humble merchants, serving Numa, the goddess of fortune. Cast out from the heavens for our greed, we have forsaken, blah 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 blah, our fleets turn the divine good, blah blah blah. So, yeah, I'm not really interested in cavaliers. I mean, we are the Reapers. They will be indoctrinated sooner or later. Another cavalier group. Holy shit. Reaper, we greet you. I will show you want to do that. I mean, it's already in my name. You should not contact me. You pass through your space in peace, only to buy to sell Ksk. Okay. Interesting. What can they actually give us? Let's be nice. We are nice little death machines of destruction. Let's greet them. What can they offer us? Ooh, 2,000 alloys. So we pay 55 crystals and get 2,000 alloys. That's good, but we don't have crystals right now. Can you wait, please? Because the alloys are needed to build ships. So they will give. Oh, you little piece of shit, I'm gonna murder you ass. You will not be indoctrinated, you will be absolutely destroyed from this universe. How dare you call me again after you warped me. You little rodent piece of shit. Ah, we got warped by rodents. This is not good. The time to build our research district has come. Oh, only 600 days, shit. Yeah, but this will help us a lot in becoming more technically advanced than every other species. Oh, fuck this. What is it? Now you. Drones. So yeah, let's just keep out of that system because the other system probably has some drones as well. So let's just skip that.
Executing evasion protocol.
And research all of this here. So what you're gonna do, we're gonna go this way first, put a station down here, and then we will expand into that direction because I don't believe there's anything here behind us. There shouldn't be an empire there, so we can safely expand there. This place will be secured with a station. Because most likely there's an empire somewhere here. I mean, we have the traders here. We will play PlayStation Station somewhere then. Down here with the Black Hole. But for now. Ooh, LOS. Interesting. I'm going to grab that.
Planetary settlement procedure.
And we got our first colony for the Reapers.
System survey.
What do we have here? Ah! Size 14. Nice. 25 months. No, we're not going to do that now. What the fuck are you? Oh, you're the slot machine guy. So... We can become a gambler if you want. And never win, because you never win with the slot machine. I don't even think you can actually win with the slot machine. It's all just a scam. So we have the EA Empire basically here. They will become indoctrinated and tell us the secrets of the slot machine. Alright, our economy is crashing, and that's because our science is absolutely high right now. No, we're not going to look for that. Now our economy is crashing. Research, damn, we research things fast. Look at this. It's not, it normally is like 50-60 months. Now look at this. It's not even 20 months to research all of that. So yeah, our economy is crashing down for one simple reason. The entire section we just built costs a lot of energy. But that's not the only thing that makes our economy crash, because we also lose food currently a lot. That's not because we have too much pops. The opposite is the fact. We don't have enough pops, so this thing gave so many jobs. Let's get also some rare crystals so that we can sooner or later build the generator segment. Now we got so many pops for that job that we don't have any more pops working in the other districts. Which is the reason why we are currently making minus in food and energy. So what we are going to do is we are going to prioritize. Yeah, it won't help if we will build the generator district as soon as possible. It would more damage us actually. So let's wait with that. So we're gonna prioritize tech to reduce the amount of energy credits we will lose every month. We have a lot of minerals which we are going to use to our advantage. We are going to sell minerals to keep our economy alive. And we kinda have to wait until we have enough pops to occupy the other jobs, and then eventually we can go build the segment to give us even more energy, and then we'll be have a lot of energy at the end. So yeah, for now we sell minerals.
Construction complete.
And buy if necessary alloys and food, because we currently don't have production for food and we have pretty much no production for alloys currently. There's also no point in our building shit on the planet because we don't have pops to occupy his jobs. So that has to wait. And we kinda have to buy our way up with minerals. Alright. Oh lol. Already. We found the L-gate! Can you even indoctrinate them? I mean, they are nanites, so I guess no. Well, if we can't indoctrinate them, then they will be destroyed. That's how we should do things.
System survey complete.
We could actually start researching that shit.
Construction complete.
Our economy is not as bad as it was before. Instead of minus 90, we got like minus 24. Food is still okay, we have enough of that. And our mineral production is so high that we should be able to keep our economy alive until we can fix it. Now, sell a few more minerals. Yeah, I know, ancient Mydones. Yeah, we found them. Let's buy a few more alloys so that we can colonize this. We could colonize it with the husks, since they can live here. Question, should we? Yeah, sure, why not? Let's rename this. How should we name this Earth-like planet where only husks live? I know, we name it Earth 2.0. Perfect. Research. Wait, why isn't it named Earth 2.0? I guess it's not Earth 2.0. The game wants it to be called Kenhial 1. Okay. Then it should be named Kenhial 1. This episode is coming to an end. So we have an L gate here and we have another gate here. Wait, it's an L gate too? We have two L gates right next to each other. What? I didn't even know that was possible, that they can spawn so close to each other, but apparently they can. Alright, we have two fucking L gates. Why not? Now we're gonna be attacked from two sides. Yay. But yeah, thank you all for watching. This is the end of the episode. And we will see you in the next one. I hope you all have a wonderful day. And goodbye.